Hello and welcome to our low power DC mini lab video. We discuss how to meet an FPGA DC voltage specification as well as AC low transient specification. We will modify and test our evaluation module using the TPS62085, a 3 ampere step down converter switching at 2.4 MHz. Now let's start with the theory.
Here we have the target specification of an Xilix FPGA. The programmable logic is specified to 1 volt plus minus 5%, and the recommended bypass and decoupling capacitor is 100 microfarad plus some high frequency decoupling caps. For us, the important spec item to meet is the 1 volt plus minus 5% for any DC variation and AC load transient changes. Now we want to calculate the DC output voltage accuracy, and the TPS62085 has a feedback regulation voltage of 800 mV plus minus 1%. We use a converter with an adjustable output, so the output voltage accuracy depends on the feedback divider accuracy. So what we see here on the graph on the right is the output voltage we program and the output voltage accuracy. So with a resistor divider of 1%, we can see the closer we program the output to the feedback regulation voltage, the better the accuracy will be. So for a 1 volt output, the overall output voltage accuracy is 1.4%. And we put in the resistor divider accuracy as well as the feedback regulation accuracy in percent. What does this mean now to our overall target window of plus minus 5%? We can see that the DC output voltage regulation takes up already this window. So for our low transient changes, we have only a target window of plus minus 36 mV. Let's calculate the required output capacitor to meet this window. We will start with the best case, so the load step takes place, the inductor current ramps up, and the output capacitor provides the remaining current. Therefore, we have an output voltage drop we can calculate. In this case, 18 mV with a 22 microfarad output capacitor. Let's use the same principle for the load release. The load step takes place, the inductor current ramps down, charging up the output capacitor, causing an output voltage overshoot. And especially for very low output voltages, this can cause an overshoot, in this case of 72 mV using a 22 microfarad output capacitor. So in order to meet the 36 mV, we either need to increase the output capacitor to 44 microfarad or use 0.1% feedback resistors. 44 microfarad is the smallest capacitor value we can use. Let's verify whether we need a large output capacitor, because we actually have a power delivery network where we need to meet a certain output impedance. The power delivery network you can see here. So the DC-DC converter has an output capacitor network with all the parasitics, just like the local bypass and high frequency decoupling capacitors. We also have a PCB, trace resistance and inductance. So when we look at the frequency domain, we can see that we need to meet a certain target impedance in order to meet our low transient response requirement. So for low frequencies, the DC-DC converter dominates the impedance, and beyond its crossover frequency, we require an output capacitor plus some high frequency decoupling and bypass capacitors to maintain a flat impedance. Now we can calculate our target impedance. For that we use this formula where we take our load drop divided by the load step, and we get 14 milliohm for our target impedance. Now beyond the crossover frequency of the DC-DC converter, the output capacitor dominates the impedance and we can calculate its value. Now we are able to complete our circuit. We place a 47 microfarad capacitor on the output. We place some high frequency decoupling and bypass capacitors as close as possible to the FPGA. Now we can go to the bench and verify if we are able to meet our plus minus 5% window. Here we have our evaluation module, where we have placed the 47 microfarad capacitor over here. We measure the load transient with this little test board. And the high frequency output capacitors are soldered directly across the output pins using a coax connector to measuring the output voltage response. Now let's have a look at our scope, where we step the load current from 100 mA up to 2.7 Ampere, and the blue trace shows now the output voltage response measured with 20 mV per division resolution at full scope bandwidth. So you can see we get rid of all the high frequency noise by using our decoupling capacitors. And last but not least, we hit our target window of plus minus 5% very nicely, as indicated by the white cursor traces.
Using a DC-DC converter with 1% feedback voltage accuracy as well as wide loop bandwidth reduces the external component count. For more information, please visit us at ti.com/powerfpga. Thanks for watching.